Good evening. The annual Plaid Pants Festival went off without a hitch this weekend. Or did it? But first up, tonight Jane has a riveting story about the effects of Potter syndrome. Jane?
Thank you, Cliff. Potter syndrome has been a serious condition since the late 90s, affecting young children and older nerds alike in an epidemic fashion.
Jane, what are you doing?
I have immersed myself in Pottermania, Cliff.
Jane, I think you misunderstood the assignment. It's the features of Potter syndrome, not Harry Potter. Pulmonary hypoplasia, oligohydramnios, twisted skin, twisted face, extremities defects, and renal agenesis. Potter.
Oh, really? Then how is it that I'm riding this broom, Cliff? That's what I thought, Cliff. Now, if you don't mind, I am late for my Quidditch match.
This just in, real Texans drink cold beer.
Ooh, I like cowboys.
No, the subunits of the brachial plexus. 5 roots, 3 trunks, 2 divisions, 3 cords, 5 branches. Real Texans drink cold beer.
You know, I dated this guy from Dallas once, and he used to be able to drink so much.
No one cares, Jane. Truly. No one cares. Good evening. We interrupt your obsession with reality television to bring you a special report. Gallstones. Yes, I said gallstones. Here is Jane with your update.
Thank you, Cliff. Gallstones. Could your patient be at risk? Just remember the 4 F's. Fat. Obesity increases the risk of cholesterol gallstones, presumably due to enhanced cholesterol synthesis and secretion. Female. Women in their 20s are nearly 3 times more likely to get gallstones than men of the same age. Though, as age increases, the sex difference tapers off. This is almost certainly due to estrogen levels, which are higher in young women than in postmenopausal women. Fertile. Frequent pregnancies and the total number of pregnancies both increase the risk of gallstones. Estrogen and progesterone change the composition of bile and promote stone formation. And finally, patients over 40 years of age.
Well played, Jane. Well played.
I know, because you're old.
Are deadly microscopic spiders hiding in your keyboard? Is peanut butter quietly killing you? These stories and more after today's topic with Jane.
Hiya. Today's topic is bacterial endocarditis. Most importantly, its signs and symptoms. Just remember me. That's right. This mnemonic is from Jane. Fever, raw spot. Osler's nodes, murmur, Janeway lesions, anemia, nail bed hemorrhage, and emboli from Jane. Even I can remember that.
That's not all you can get from Jane.
What was that, Cliff?
Oh, nothing. When we return, out of work ninjas enter the workforce. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Up next, the claustrophobic cabinet maker was cocooned in his own creation.
Oh my gosh, you just used like 4 C's in a row.
It's called alliteration, Jane. It's that kind of flair that's going to finally win me that local Emmy over that damn cocky Steve Shaw.
Well, the signs and symptoms of Huntington's disease are also 4 C's.
Jane, that's irrelevant. We were talking about me finally beating that old...
What was that? I tend to zone out when you talk. As I was saying, the four C's of Huntington's are chorea, caudate loses acetylcholine, CAG repeats, and corenta.
Can we just fire her already? Excuse me? What do you mean I don't have that kind of pull? I am the face of this program!
Sorry, Cliff. Seems as though we're the face of this program.
And so the scientist concluded that the radioactivity in the lake will probably not affect tomorrow's swim meet. And now over to Jane for what I hope to God is just a regular weather forecast. Of course not. That would be too easy.
Do you know which DNA virus is associated with milkmaid's blisters?
No, but I bet you're about to tell me.
My friend here can give you a little hint.
Really, Bill? Have you no self-respect?
The DNA virus associated with milkmaid's blisters is cowpox. Get it? Cowpox? Do it again, Bill.
Moo.
This just in. Bill, you're fired. Welcome back. Now with our ever-enlightening topic of the week, hematology, here is Jane.
Thank you, Cliff. Which bones in adults synthesize red blood cells, or RBCs? Vertebrae, sternum, pelvis, cranial bones, and ribs.
Jane, what are you doing? This is a serious news show.
What? Sweeps week.